Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Learn English. Do you ask questions? Yes, obviously we all do. But are you doing it correctly in English? So here I am. Today I'll help you to improve your structures of questions in English. So let's begin. Today I'll be talking about two types of questions, open questions and closed questions. Have you observed there are questions which can be answered only by a simple yes or no? These questions are closed questions. For example, are you learning English? Your answer would be yes, I am, or no, I'm not. If I ask you, did you subscribe to the channel? I hope your reply is yes. These questions are closed questions that are answered with a yes or no, right or wrong, true or false. Another type of questions are open questions. These questions require more thought and more than just a plain yes or no. For example, if I ask you, why do you want to learn English? Your answer won't be a yes or no. You would have many reasons, right? These open questions use WH family words and how. It will be discussed in the next video. Now let's come back to closed questions, today's topic. These closed questions are made with the help of auxiliary verb or modal verbs. For example, can, could, do, does, did, is, am, are, was, were, etc. Now remember, these questions always follow a fixed pattern. For example, first comes the auxiliary verb and then comes the pronoun or subject. For example, are you feeling better today? Is she working today? Was this idea interesting? Am I right? All these questions follow a fixed pattern. First comes the auxiliary verb in the beginning of the sentence and then comes the pronoun followed by the main verb. Now there are two rules you must follow while making these questions. First is the subject must match the auxiliary verb. For example, I am a teacher. Now you use am with I. To form a question, you would ask, am I a teacher? Right? Another example, do you love milk? So here do is used with the subject. To know more about the usage of do, does and did, you can click on this link and go to our previous video. Another rule is intonation. Intonation means the rise and fall of the voice when I'm speaking. For example, listen carefully. Are you the new girl? Did you join the class? Is this your pen? In all these questions, my voice is rising at the end of the sentence. Listen again. Do you have a pen? No, no, no. So these kind of questions, closed questions, have rising intonation at the end of the question. Alright, now let's revise what all we have done today. Closed questions are the questions which demand a yes or no, true or false, or right or wrong type of answer. These questions are formed with the help of auxiliary verb or modal verbs, and they have a rising intonation at the end of the sentence. That's all for today. In the next video, I'll teach you how to form open questions, open-ended questions that are formed with the help of WH family words and how. Stay tuned. Do not forget to subscribe. Thank you. Bye-bye.